Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for February the 7th of 2020, well, it is titled NGC 7331 Close Up. So what do we see here? Well, this is the galaxy known by the catalog designations of NGC 7331. And it is an example of a spiral galaxy, much like our own Milky Way. And we can see the distinct spiral structure. And how we see this galaxy is a matter of how it happens to be orientated towards us. Some galaxies are seen face on, where we're looking straight down on them and can see the great spiral arms. Others are seen edge on, and there we see them just almost as a flat disk with their great dusty areas. This one we see in between. It's looking at somewhat of an angle, so we can see some of the spiral arms and can also see a lot of the dustier areas as well. Now, within a spiral galaxy, star formation is going on. And there are two things that sort of show that to us, and some of that is within the spiral arms. We see lots of great blue star clusters. Blue stars, massive blue stars like these, when they form, when stars are forming, and they do not live a very long time. Many of these stars only live a few million years. And while a few million years may be an extremely long time for us, it is not all that long for a star. Many stars, like our sun, live 10 billion years, and smaller stars live even longer, hundreds of billions or even a trillion years. So stars that live only a few million years must have formed within the last couple of million years, otherwise they would not be around any longer. So you'd not be able to see them. Had these stars formed, say, 20 million years ago, they'd already be gone. So the fact that we can still see them today means that they must have formed relatively recently. Another thing that we see here is a lot of red within the spiral arms. The red is caused by hydrogen gas within star-forming regions. So when those blue stars form, they emit a lot of ultraviolet light. We see them as blue, but most of their light is actually put out in the ultraviolet portion of the spectrum, and that means they are able to excite the hydrogen gas around them and cause it to glow. When hydrogen gas is excited, it gives off a distinct red color, and we can see that in the red emission regions scattered around here as well. Now, as we move into the central portion of the galaxy, we see that the coloring changes from a distinct bluish tint to the spiral arms to a much yellower color. And that means we're getting a mixture of older and younger stars there. And in fact, probably a lot of red giant stars, they're evolved stars that are adding their light and changing the coloration as we work down towards the center. And of course, at the very center here, much like our own galaxy, would be a supermassive black hole, millions of times the mass of our sun. And that is at the center of most galaxies and actually causes some activity and some energy to be emitted as material spirals in to that black hole. However, an important thing to remember is that black holes do not suck in everything they see. So a black hole is not sucking in all the material of this galaxy. It simply orbits around the black hole, much as it would if it were any other kind of matter. It is only when we get close to a black hole that the interesting effects start to occur, and that means getting very close to it. So the central regions of the galaxy, some unusual things would be going on, the very central core beyond what we can even resolve at this level. But when we're further away, nothing much really changes. And a common example is, could you turn our sun into a black hole right now, just crush it down to a black hole, then the Earth would continue to orbit just as it always would. If the mass of the sun does not change, just compress the matter down to a black hole, then the Earth would orbit it just as it orbits the sun at this point. So nothing would actually change for the Earth, other than that it would get rather cold and dark without the heat and light that we are used to getting from the sun. So here we get to see a nice Hubble Space Telescope image of NGC 7331, a nearby spiral galaxy. So that was our picture of the day for February the 7th of 2020. It was titled NGC 7331 Close Up. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.